Hi, everyone. Thank you for inviting us. It's not often you get to address a conference wearing a boa, so I thought I'd just give it a go here, so I put my camper boa on. I'm just going to spend a few minutes to try and demystify what we do out in the van. So Donald Trump, a few weeks ago in the State of the Union address, declared that he would promote the common good. And when he said that, my heart sank, because it's really regrettable that he kind of tainted the ancient concept of the common good. For it's here that the camper van story begins. In 2014, listening to an American activist talk of social justice protests sparked the idea for the camper of dreams. He declared that civic activism, he related civic activism to Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream speech. And I want you to look beyond, look beyond the great man himself to the crowds behind him. Because a movement is made possible when millions of people make personal decisions. History is changed by personal commitment. And if enough people have a vision and commit, a social movement is generated. So the question for us was, how do we create conditions for people or society to flourish? The camper van of dreams is a 1970s VW camper. It's parked out there. And it's a vehicle of nostalgia. On a journey, people stop and stare, children wave, geezers come over and talk to Simon about restoration, and then there's the communal push at the inevitable breakdown. So touring around, we realise that the van itself created an invitation for people to connect. Sorry, this is playing up on a timer. Developing the concept at Culture Night Belfast, we turned the camper of dreams into a dream-enabling van, and we welcomed people into the van, recognising the importance of creating space. Based on the premise that if you make a declaration, it becomes a possibility to live towards, people enter the camper and are invited to speak a hope or a dream, something that matters to them, to connect and reflect and make a declaration. People speak dreams in the sanctuary of the van. It's like a sparkly confessional parlour. But the dreams are declared on a megaphone and it comes out the roof, becoming a public declaration. The dreams become a positive, audible stream, a collective movement, a random act of hope for bystanders around the van. All the dreams are written on ribbons and tied to our dream catcher. Sometimes it's a big 10-foot one, today we have a wee one. And it becomes a visual installation of possibility. We tweet the dreams to enable people to connect online and collate themes for communities, organisations and events. And since we have begun, over 4,000 people have entered the van. In many settings, people of all ages, dreaming big and small, and taking a risk, speaking from the heart. The camper has had many opportunities to interface and cross boundaries. We've been to schools and festivals, working with refugees, people in colleges, Democracy Day. It's been an absolute pleasure. But I want to talk just for 2 minutes about what we do with healthcare. Simon, Marie-Louise and I all work in healthcare, and we've been able to park up in various settings, inviting people to challenge paradigms in personal and population health, to dream of different services and societal structures of how we care for each other. It has given voice to frontline workers who know the pressures and failings of the health service, but crucially also hold the insight into better care. We've enabled people to come into our sanctuary of the confessional and to be bold to speak truth to hierarchy, to start a collective hope amongst colleagues. It's so lovely when people gather in the van together, and hope of change and improvement, and also to introduce psychological safety, a space to take a risk or to call for a shift in culture. The current health strategy has co-production with service users at its core. And the camper has enabled voices from patients, children in care, people attending mental health services to speak loud, be acknowledged and encouraged. And this is where the magic happens. The power of narrative is central to transformation. It is the start of rehabilitation for a person or a system. And it's so lovely to share it. Importantly also, the camper has welcomed NHS decision makers, chief execs, consultants, senior civil servants, to come in and reimagine health and social care. We've been invited to conferences and workshops in the Royal College of Surgeons in Ireland, Health Trust, NICON, and this represents the IHI conference in Amsterdam, that notorious conference. By entering the van, we have given permission to leaders to believe, to dream, and declare a vision for their services, their staff, and population health. To envisage the conditions for society to flourish, for these leaders to be innovative, and to support a social movement. I just want to finish with a very brief story about the van crossing an interface. In 2017, on the winter solstice, the camper van was invited to take part in a Day of Hope in Highbank Wood Prison, organised by the mental health team, creating space on a cold winter's day for people to flourish. We parked the van in the middle of the prison yard and invited people to come in and speak hopes. The prison choir came in and sang Jailhouse Rock as the camper swayed to the raucous beat. Then a lady who was in prison for many, many years came in and decided to sing Silent Night. This was relayed across the whole prison to the camper tannoys, and it was beautiful and poignant. And when she hit a bum high note, it was totally hilarious. It was a moment of pure joy. The next day, I tweeted all the dreams anonymously. There were dreams of family, love, connection, and new beginnings. And as I tweeted, I realized it was impossible to tell the difference between prisoner, officer, and healthcare staff, because hope is the human condition of the heart. So today, you're going to get a cup of tea now, a well-deserved cup of tea, and you're going to have time later on at lunchtime to come and enter the van, and we would love you to come and share. We'd like to invite you to come in to the van to get to chat to each other, to recognise what really matters. And I think together we can believe, and we can change healthcare, and we can change society, and we can change each other for the common good. Thank you. So please step outside and come and join us. Thank you.